them. And now we are back with our panel, Byron, Marie, and Matt. And so taking us back to the 2012 campaign cycle with Mitt Romney jumping in today. Take a listen to this.
I have decided to run for United States Senate because I believe I can help bring Utah's values and Utah's lessons to Washington.
We don't want government to be so far away from us, so removed from our community. Mitt Romney represents more of that.
And I think there are some people who may have run that won't based on a Mitt Romney candidacy.
So conventional wisdom in this town is if Mitt Romney gets in, he's going to win. Is he going to win?
I don't know if he's going to win, but I mean, I find this all rather pathetic. He ran for president. He got trounced. A lot of people thought he was going to win. He had a good first debate, but I think it's time for Governor Romney from Massachusetts, maybe future senator from Utah, to just kind of find something else to do. Maybe get a hobby, play golf, learn how to knit, go traveling, something else.
He's already being hit with the carpetbagger thing. Marie, your reaction?
Look, I think, and I worked on the campaign against Mitt Romney in 2012. I think Mitt Romney is actually a dedicated public servant, a good person. I suspect he will win. What will be interesting is what kind of candidate he is and then what kind of senator he is, especially in his relationship with President Trump. They've had this sort of on again, off again. He criticized him during the campaign in 2016. Then he was up for Secretary of State and they got closer. That will be interesting to watch what role he plays if indeed he wins.
I don't think there's any question he's going to win. I think one question is, why does he want to do this?
Yeah.
Because he's going to come to Washington. He's going to distance himself from the president because the president dominates everything here. Mm-hmm. Trump will say something outrageous. He will condemn it. And then he will end up voting with the president 90%+ of the time. And I'm not sure exactly why he wants to do that.
I've had a lot of senators come up to me and say they're scratching their heads trying to figure out why he wants the gig. Okay, winners and losers. Byron, start us off.
My winner is Amy Sherald. She is the artist whose portrait of Michelle Obama was unveiled this week. What you didn't hear at the ceremony was that she, at age 31, was diagnosed with heart failure, very, very serious, and in 2012 had a heart transplant.
So awesome.
She's there, the picture of health and success, and had overcome an enormous number of challenges. My loser is Senator Bob Corker. He made a big show of opposing the president. Remember that? He called the White House adult daycare. Mm-hmm. And now he made a big show of declining to run for re-election, and now he says he might want to run again, except he would need the support of the adult daycare center.
And Marsha Blackburn's not going anywhere, and she's apparently been
Absolutely
talking to the president,
not.
So that's complicated. Marie, your winners and losers?
My winners this week are the U.S. Olympians, but specifically 17-year-old Chloe Kim. She's from California. She won the gold in the women's halfpipe, and she was the first female Olympian to hit back-to-back 1080s, which is a very difficult move in the halfpipe event. And she's just this great character. She's 17. I wasn't winning gold medals at 17.
No,
she's just this great Olympian. There's a bunch of other great ones, too. My loser, though, this week are Russian internet bots, to go off our earlier story. You know, they've been put on notice and they've been named and shamed, which is a tool of diplomacy. And hopefully this administration will be making it harder for them. And Americans will now know to look out for them on the internet. And so this may be the start of really cracking down on some of Russia's internet disinformation behavior. They're my loser of the week.
Matt?
Winner, Kevin Cramer, congressman from North Dakota, who I think will be the next senator from North Dakota as he takes on Heidi Heitkamp. And my loser, I hate to go back to it, my loser, partly because Marie seems to love him so much, would be Mitt Romney. Like I said, I think it's time to find a hobby and to move on and to give someone else a chance.
So Cramer just jumping in today.
That's right.
You think he plays well?
As we're speaking.
In a state that President Trump did well in 2016?
Absolutely. He's won by double digits. He's very popular. Obviously, it's an at-large House race, so he runs statewide every time. I think Heidi Heitkamp has something to be nervous about.
All right. Stay tuned. Another winner of the week.